Hello everyone. Today I'm going to show you guys a small demonstration, and I want to talk to you about different type of transmission fluids. There is factory. I have a few examples: Toyota, Honda, and Ford Mercury transmission fluids. And they all have different specifications, but they all provide the same thing: lubricate transmission components, and they provide, they cool off the transmission components as well, and as provide other other types of properties or other types of things for the transmissions to perform well in terms of providing less slippage, things of that nature. And one of the things that I want to start with is basically a cold flow. You know, cold flow, how the transmission fluid flows when it's cold. So I have some samples in a box. They've been sitting outside for about 12 hours, not 12, yeah, about more than 12 hours at a different, at the temperature about 12 degrees. So I'm gonna pull it out and I'm gonna set them next to each other, across. So the Toyota WS, I have a Ford ATF. This is used WS transmission fluid, Honda, Amsoil, and type 4. So these are the four different samples that I have. And I have little bottles too that I'm gonna actually demonstrate the actual cold flow. Let's see the color difference. Here is Amsoil fluid color, WS color, and they go in our type. This is used WS, type 4, Honda, and Ford Mercury 5 transmission fluid. So they all been sitting outside at a temperature of about 10-12 degrees Fahrenheit. So let's measure the temperature fluid. So right there it shows 32. It's below 32, I know for sure. Let's take a look at how cold now, for example, WS transmission fluid, and as you can see, it's interesting. Then WS, it's more like, it looks like to me more like a water. Yeah, not as the viscosity, definitely noticeable. And then if we look at the used WRS, type 4. Yeah, type 4 is more viscous. There's a lot more viscosity, as you can see. What about Honda ATF? And Ford Mercury or Motorcraft Mercury. They all look very close. So the test that I want to do today is I want to see how well it flows at a cold temperature. So which fluid starts flowing faster? Not sure if camera can pick it up or not. As you can see, it's dripping. Not sure, maybe camera will pick it up, maybe not. Soil, Toyota WS, used WS, type 4 Toyota fluid, Honda transmission fluid, and Ford ATF Mercury transmission fluid. And because the fluid is cold, so it's some specifications that I was able to pull out from online source, actually online on the website to search for it, you know, it's all there. There is no such a thing as one fluid that fits or meets all the specifications of every car, year and make and model. No, there are specific years, specific makes and models, different type of fluid meets, you know what I mean? So there is no one fluid that meets every year and every make. So for one particular type, from one year to another year, there is one type, and then for different years, different type of fluids. So let's look at our sample. None of them actually running. They're all dripping. One more thing I want to mention to you guys is transmission fluid. Actually, the transmission themselves or the fluids for the transmissions are designed in terms of providing better fuel efficiency, not in terms of providing better protection. They are better than the previous generation transmission fluids. Like, for example, Type WS is better than Type 4, as you've seen it in, according to the specs. But viscosity is different, much higher on Type 4 than WS. And the reason why, because it all comes down to the fuel efficiency. Less drag, you know what I mean? It's not synthetic, and it does not even come close in providing the same protection as synthetic fluid does. And for example, WS fluid, transmission fluid, is formulated with the friction modifier additives that delivers outstanding clutch holding capacity, static friction, torque transferability, anti-shredder properties, meaning slipping in torque converter clutches, and it's good, it was still good after 180,000 miles in the vehicle. Imagine that. You run a fluid for 180,000 and it was still good. If you run a factory fluid for 180,000, well, it's not just the fluid is going to be bad. Even the transmission, in many cases, will have so much wear on it that it's, well, aftermarket transmission fluid cause any damage to the transmission. It all depends. Depends on the aftermarket brand. Amsoil has been tested in the field, in a taxi cab, and test results are available. All other aftermarket brands, there hasn't been any field studies done by the manufacturers. For example, Mobil, they make transmission fluid, but you know, people are using it, but is there any proof that it's better than factory? I don't know. There is no any test results available on their website or any other aftermarket. So if you want the best, I would recommend using Amsoil. That's what I'm using in my own cars. You can check my web channel. I have done many updates. I have performed on the U660E transmission change recently, and it shifts very smoothly. Holds it holds the gears. Well, it holds in one gear at a higher speed much better, so less, you know, hunting, searching for what's the right gear. It holds better, but if you ask me, does it slow to shift? No, it's not slow. Seems like Honda ATF went out faster versus others, but at the same time, look at the Amsoil, it's doing pretty good. Look at the Amsoil versus Toyota WS. That's pretty amazing. And the reason why Honda ATF went down much faster, I'm not sure what's the viscosity. And maybe viscosity, maybe it's like a water or something, you know what I mean? Very little viscosity, very small unit of viscosity. So right there, that's amazing, you know? All went down except Ford. Ford is struggling. Also, by the way, factory transmission fluid is not designed to provide you to provide the best protection for the transmission. It's designed to provide, in terms of providing better fuel efficiency, for the car overall. That's the main reason why there are a lot of transmission failures in these days, because transmission fluids, their viscosities are they're much less, more like watered down, basically, in terms so you get better fuel economy. But Amsoil transmission fluid, I have noticed on mine, it actually went up, you know, it's more a viscosity unit of measure is higher, just a little bit, not much, but because it's synthetic, so synthetic fluid will act differently versus non-synthetic. So that's something I want to stress out, that if you're afraid or if you think not sure how it's going to act in your car, you know what I mean, you can try it. You can do research, you know what I mean. Here is the thing. When I switched mine U660E transmission from WS to Amsoil, I was like, I didn't know what to expect, you know. I'm like, well, if it fails on me, it's not going to provide me what I'm looking for. I'll start seeing the how that it's going to shift differently in terms of bad shifting, slippage, torque converter issues. I will drain and put it back original WS. But it worked fine. No issues. Shifts much better. Overall, it just, I can't, there is nothing that I can say bad about this Amsoil transmission fluid. Nothing. Not a single thing. I don't, you know what I mean? Not a single complaint. Nothing like, oh man, I wish they would have done it a little bit, something different. There's nothing I can say. There's nothing I can add to it in terms of being a bad fluid or not providing the protection or not working out for me. It works great. But I'll use it on my every single vehicle. If you like to purchase Amsoil products, feel free. There'll be a link in my description. Contact me. You know, if you have a business or you know someone who has a business and they can greatly benefit, you know what I mean, by using this product, or you personally want to benefit from it, you know, sign up as a preferred customer. Or if you have a business, you want to learn how to save on your maintenance, how to buy at wholesale price, send me email, call me, you know, there will be information on the website, and the link in my description. So don't forget to subscribe.